What does it mean to be an American to you?
Anyone with freedom and the passion to succeed.
Just be nice to others, pretty much. Don't just outcast someone.
Being an American means that we don't all have to think the same thing. But in general, holding to the ideology of what's in our Constitution, our Bill of Rights, and the things that we were founded on.
Being an American, I feel like right now, just means being big, fat, and dumb. Like, it can be really good. There are really good Americans, and we can be really awesome, but a lot of times we kind of miss the mark.
Doesn't look. The First Amendment protects the freedoms that define what it means to be an American, such as the freedom of religion,
freedom of speech,
the freedom of the press,
freedom of assembly,
and the freedom to petition the government. The
First Amendment is important for the media and also for the students. And it's also important for the government.
We are a country that has welcomed people of every race and every faith. We are home to Muslims who worship across our country. We not only respect the freedom of religion, we have laws that protect individuals from being harmed because of how they look or what they believe. Our Constitution protects the right to practice free speech.
Well, public access, a big part of it is people's ability to express their First Amendment rights. It's really a kind of an electronic soapbox, if you will. We teach people how to use cameras and microphones and lights so that then they have the tools to go out and video themselves and talk about their passions or their ideas and then share them with the community, with the idea being that it creates a dialogue, a democratic dialogue among the greater community so that people can kind of hash out, you know, hey, is this a good idea or is it not? You know, what can we do to keep our waterways clean? You know, what can we do to keep our government transparent and so on and so forth?
The way I would maybe try and look at that is to sort of compare what we have here in this country with what you might have in a country that doesn't have that right, where you are restricted in what you can say and you are restricted with what you can read in the newspaper and what you can find on the internet. I think it gives us a lot of power, a lot of opportunity. It obviously can be a challenge sometimes, but I think the benefits of it outweigh some of that. And leave us in a better place. We're more informed. We're more connected. We have a better grasp of kind of the reality around us than we would if we were, you know, living in a country where we didn't have that freedom and what we could access was more limited. We wouldn't be nearly as well educated and as aware of, you know, what's going on around us.
The First Amendment is important for every American. The First Amendment allows us to speak on issues that we are passionate about.
Okay, so I think it really has protected me as a journalist just because, you know, obviously I can't go on screen and say whatever the hell I want and say, F this, F that. But it has helped me to be able to let people know, like, what I care about or build opinions on it on screen. It has allowed me to really mold myself as a journalist. I feel like it's really, not only has it protected me, it's built me.
Mary Beth Tinker is an American free speech activist who is known for her role in the landmark student free speech case, Tinker versus Des Moines. She has been defending students' First Amendment rights since herself was a student protesting the Vietnam War with a black armband.
Young people make such a difference when it comes to striving towards our ideals, our democratic ideals, justice, equality. Everyone should have a voice, and that's where young people are so powerful. It was never thought that the First Amendment covered young people, and young people have always been a group that has been discriminated against in our democracy. So slowly over time, the idea has been evolving that young people do have rights. And the case Tinker versus Des Moines, which was decided in 1969, helped to push us forward in the idea that young people do have rights and that young people do have First Amendment rights especially.
Many people don't know all the parts to the First Amendment or understand it.
The First Amendment gives us the right to religious freedom, speech, petition, there's a few more.
The First Amendment is the right of the people for freedom of speech, freedom of press, and for them.
According to the 2018 State of the First Amendment survey, conducted by the First Amendment Center of Freedom Forum Institute, 36% of people could not name all the parts of the First Amendment.
While some people think that the First Amendment allows us to say and do whatever we want with no consequences, that's not how it works. There are consequences to what you say and do in life, but it does protect us from any law and punishments from Congress. Congress cannot limit or prohibit the freedoms of the First Amendment.
In a diverse society, efforts to restrict speech can quickly become a tool to silence critics and oppress minorities.
The First Amendment protects the freedoms that enable us to make our country what we want it to be and to ensure it is on the path it is set out to be.
The First Amendment is what it means to be an American.